Hey guys, welcome back to our channel. My name is Yavin from YourEasyFilm.com and today we're gonna talk about what are the best render settings for your YouTube videos in Premiere Pro. Let's go! So, if we have finished a project, it's time to export the video. We're gonna do this by pressing Ctrl and M. Now it will open up a new window with the export settings. Most important thing, our format and also the preset. I would highly recommend to use H.64 for the best quality. The next step is the preset. We're gonna select this and scroll down to the YouTube section. Usually 1080p Full HD is more than enough, but I would still highly recommend using the 4K preset. Because at the moment Full HD is the standard, but I'm pretty sure in 4 or maybe 5 years 4K will be the standard and then all your older YouTube videos are in the standard quality. At this part you can name your sequence to whatever you want. Just make sure that you select export video and also export audio. Then we're gonna scroll down to the effects. Usually there's no need to change anything, but I would highly recommend using the loudness normalization because all your videos will now have the same noise level. And the users watching your videos don't need to change the loudness on their phone or their computer. So here are the basic video settings. We are at 4K resolution and a frame rate of 24 frames per second. At least for a YouTube video, there's not really much to think about. The only thing I would recommend is hitting render at maximum depth. So if we're gonna go to the audio settings, just make sure the audio quality is on high and not on low or medium. But that should be automatically selected. So this icon will tell you that it gives you better render quality, but it will also increase your encoding time. So to be honest, I don't see any difference if I hit that button or not, but at least why wouldn't you want the maximum render quality? So just hit that button. So if you have done some work for a client, you can also select this icon, set start timecode, then the video will encode it by timecode and the client can easily tell you at this time he wants you to change something. And then we're gonna go to export. If you still have something more to work, you should use the QE button because it will automatically open up your media encoder and it will render out your video and you can still edit in Premiere Pro. If you're definitely done for today, you can just click export and it will export immediately with the current settings. Okay guys, that was the quick video about the best render settings for your YouTube videos. I hope I could help you out. If I did, please leave me a like and a comment. Don't forget to subscribe and see you in the next video. Peace out.